Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over report formulas in Salesforce. Report formulas allow you to report on things that may not necessarily already be within Salesforce. Now that might sound a little confusing, but let's go ahead and jump into an example and get this moving. Let's go ahead and go to reports, new report. I want to go to an opportunity report. Okay, let's go ahead and change some of these filters so we have data to work with. Also, if you update the preview automatically, you won't have to save and it'll update whenever you make changes. I'm going to get rid of any empty data or data that we might not need. All right, that looks pretty good. Okay, and one thing about report formulas is that you do need to have a grouping before you get started. So I'm going to group this by stage. If I can spell. Okay, so now that we've grouped this by stage, as you can see, we have everything here. Let's jump into our business scenario. So I want to create a way to see what the expected commission would be off of these opportunities. It's a way that we can incentivize our different sales reps to keep going, be more motivated based upon what they would possibly receive in commission from this any opportunity. So now we click this little icon, we go to create formula. All right, now here we can create a formula. We can enter in some of the different fields. I'm going to have this be anticipated commission. Okay, and then it'll be a number field. And I want to display it on everything. All right, so now we're gonna do this off of the expected revenue. So we'll grab that field, insert it, and then to get the commission, it'll be around 20%, which honestly, that could be really off on what commissions actually are. This is just for the example. I'm going to hit apply. And so now we do have the anticipated commission, and it is here for each grouping and a subtotal. So anything that's in prospecting would be 200, qualification is 30, value proposition, and so on and so forth when you get down to a grand total of what the expected commission would be. From here, we can go ahead and save and run this. I'm going to have this be opportunities with commissions. And of course, if you have a more complicated commission base, then you'd be able to do this maybe through revenue splits or whatnot. So let's go ahead and hit save here. And it'll take us to the report viewer and we should be able to see our commission over here. All right, and that is a very basic overview of report formulas. And of course, this is a formula and so it could be just completely wild and have it be a really complicated formula for your complicated business scenario. But this is just a quick little overview for you. Don't be afraid to play around with all this data as long as you're not changing the source information, like the opportunities on the record, and this isn't a private folder. No one else is going to be able to see it. So just play around and try and answer the question that you came to the report to answer. So thank you so much for joining me. I will leave a link to my reporting series playlist that I started back in December of last year if you'd like to learn more about reporting. Like and subscribe if you found this video helpful. Be sure to check out the courses down below in the description. You can subscribe to the email list at salesforceemily.com and I'll catch you guys in the next one.